Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending when you are watching this, at the time you are watching this. Welcome to the channel. My name is Fred, for those who are new to my channel. And I created this channel to educate dairy farmers on dairy rearing, on dairy venture. So today, I'm going to show you how to plant the Super Napier Pakchong. The Super Napier is a fodder for cows, which has a crude protein of 18%. Yeah. So what are you supposed to do? What do you need when you're planting Super Napier? One, you have to dig holes. Yeah. That is 4 centimeters by 4 centimeters. And you have to fill the hole with manure, like as you see. Yeah. You have to determine the spacing between one hole to the other. Yeah, you see. So I have isolated this space so that I can plant Super Napier grass. Yesterday it rained at night, so today is the best day to plant. As you can see, I've created a hole and I have added manure. Yeah, so it's a simple thing to do. Anyone can do it. And as a dairy farmer, you have to invest in fodder, take advantages of the rains. Yeah. And I believe with 3 months time, I'll be able to harvest my Super Napier, but I'm not planning to harvest it. I want it to overgrow so that I can have more cuttings, so that I can remove the old style Napier grass and add in those areas that you can see, and I add Super Napier. So let's go direct to the point, go direct to the steps that you are supposed. So the first thing that you need is dig a hole. Yeah, once you dig a hole, you have to add manure. Yeah, remember, first of all, we have to feed the soil, because all nutrients come from the soil. So the first thing that you need, you have to take care of the soil by adding more manure. Here are the cuttings. You can see I bought them yesterday, and here inside there are very many. So there are all these are cuttings, and I bought them at $2,500. That's like $25. We have fertilizer. This is 17 17 17. Yeah, and I'm going to use it to add when I'm planting. So you have a sprit here. You see, this one is a healthy sprit. As you can see, you have to dip it diagonally. As you see, these are hole. You have to dip it like this diagonally, and then at the top soil. But you have to the top has to remain like that. Yeah, and then you go to the second one, and then you do the same. You plant it diagonally like that, and then add that. So let me take my fertilizer. So that I can add a retro fertilizer for each hole. Yeah, so what I'm doing is, first of all, I want to enrich the soil with nutrient. So as you can see, we have so I can keep a retro per hole, as you can see. So you need that. You need to add a retro fertilizer, because I want these as much as the soil has nutrients, the better for your crop that you are planting. In this case, the Super Napier that we are planting. Remember, the spacing should not be so small. Yeah, like you see, these are good spacing, because this Napier will grow and will occupy a lot of space. Yeah, so you should observe that. The first thing that we have said is the soil nutrient. You should have soil that have nutrients. So here are the steps for recap for those who have not known or who have not understood. You have to dig the hole first, and you have to give a separate, this way is called a tubukiza method. Yeah, once you dig a hole, you have to fill it with manure. There's a good quality manure, you have to fill it, and then you can add a little fertilizer that I have, like you have seen, and then you have your cuttings. So for Napier, we use cuttings, as you see. So these are the cuttings, and then you plant those cuttings. Yeah, so per hole it will take just two cuttings, and then you have to, because we have rain, like you see here, because we have rain, we are not going to water these. Yeah, so for every hole you have to have two, and then you can add the top soil. So, and then to make it more complete, you have, like you see, these are leaves from trees that I have cut. Then you can keep leaves like that, such that there will be no evaporation. Even if you are going to water it, there will be no evaporation, and your cuttings will germinate well. So that is it, guys. I would like to thank you for those who have watched the video, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, please support me by subscribing to my channel, and I'm looking forward to give more information, to keep on educating, giving tips to farmers and dairy farmers and upcoming dairy farmers. So thank you for your time, and may you have a great day. So thank you.